Right, guys, it's Jamie here from GEOSynths again. So we're going to carry on and do some more patching. Now, we did the pad sound before. Which is a nice expressive type of sound. Now, sometimes what I like to do is counteract that with something a little bit more, delicate, I suppose. And what's more delicate? Well, an arpeggiated sound over the top. So that's what we're going to do. First thing we need to do is we're going to stack it. So you'll have then a sawtooth from layer B coming over the top. Now, because we want to concentrate on this arpeggiator, what we want to do is reduce the volume of layer A. So making sure, even though it's just stack A and B, light is lit. Okay, so we're going to go to miscellaneous parameters. It'll come up with a program value. If not, you just have to move it along with the parameter knob and then just turn it down to zero. So then all we've got is layer B. Make sure we select layer B. And one thing to be cautious about, once you write the patch, it will disable this button, edit layer B, and you could then end up carrying on tweaking layer A without knowing it. So it's just something to be careful of. Now we've got this pad. There's a bit of sort of mid-range sound in it, so we want something a little bit higher up, but maybe a little softer. So let's have a listen at what we've got. So there's a sawtooth. We did saw try for the pad for oscillator one. Triangle. Pulse. So I reckon we'll just go with a triangle. Nice and soft. Now, if we want to make that a bit more buzzier, you'd think, well, maybe go to the saw try, but no, you can actually just use the shape mod. Get some upper harmonics. But then we'll just turn it off for now. Okay, so really, it's still going to be a sort of fast attack. There might be a bit of clickiness going on, but it's still a fast attack with that. So a lot of what we'll be doing will be with the decay. So go to the amp envelope, attack, it's pretty much full on. Turn down the sustain and turn down the release for now. So as you know, moving the decay, go on forever if it's long, and that if it's short. So you'd think just have it short, but actually we can do that with a filter envelope. So let's just have it a little bit. Then sustain, we don't need to turn that up really, because it's going to be repeating. Release, add a fair bit of that. Bit of clicking, so we can just move on the envelope attack a little bit. I mean, some synths are different than the others. Some, I mean, the clicking isn't that there's anything wrong, it's just that the volume isn't starting at 0 point. But we might be able to get rid of some of that with filter. I mean, you've got up until about sort of 10 anyway. Anyway, we'll mess around with that later on. So at the moment, I've just got it on about, I don't know, 4. Now, what I do like to do with arpeggiated sounds is use the pan spread. So let's just add a little bit of that while we're in the amp section. Got it around 73 at the moment. Envelope amount, we just have that on full. There's no point sort of messing around with that because it's not really doing a great deal. not a lot of synths really have a separate envelope amount for volume. Velocity we don't need to need, don't need, and delay we don't need either. So what we can also do now is add another oscillator. Now bear in mind, if we have something really bright, it's going to take over that. Listening for there isn't what it's really sounding now, it's what it could sound like ahead of time once it's filtered, what's going to stick through, you know, because then you can have one sound, one oscillator that's going to be the high harmonics and the other bit just to fill out the body. So you're asking questions as you're listening to it, you kind of, you're thinking ahead of yourself. So I'm thinking, okay, what oscillator shall I use to fill out the body? I'm also thinking, what if I change the pitch of one of the oscillators, or even both? Bearing in mind that we've got this big pad that's going to be sitting underneath it. So at the moment, it's still a triangle, but I've got the shape mod on about 81%. Now, what we need to do now, you know, say for instance, with other synths, we have different volume faders for each oscillator, but here we don't, we have a knob, a mix knob, so the brightness is a little bit overpowering, maybe, there's no right or wrong, so we're going to mess with the oscillator mix. Oscillator 1, oscillator 2. Now they sound like they're an octave different, but they're actually the same. Actually, I was wrong, they're not, they're an octave out. Messing earlier on, sorry. So C3 for oscillator 2. C3 oscillator 1, but we're going to go an octave higher, I think, for oscillator 1. Go C4. Move the oscillator mix more over to oscillator 1. Hear how that changes the wave shape, just by volume. Now we're doing that, now that could be an idea that we could use for modulation. But we'll see. So just for now, oscillator mix, I've got it about 43, something like that. So let's go to the filter. So let's turn the cutoff all the way down, envelope amount all the way up. Then turn off all your ADSRs. Make sure audio mod's off, key amount. To say it's a tilting table with key amount, but that's from C2. Now, there's no way I figured out anyway of altering that, so we can sometimes make it, you change it and it'll still be bright. Don't worry about it for now. I'm going off on a tangent, which I do. So what we need to do is just bring up. Now the attack, we don't really need to have a slow attack, so it's really all in the decay. A little bass sound. So by having that amp decay a bit longer, we're using the filter decay for the length of the sound. Whereas you may, sort of common sense may think, oh, well, no, you do use the amp for that. That's the volume, but no, use the filter. Because then you've always got it there. If you need to, you can modulate. So I've got about 79. So if you think, okay. So you'll have to excuse me because I've got a bit of a runny nose today for some reason. We will add a little bit of velocity. huge difference at the moment, but we need to reduce the envelope amount for that. So let's just knock that down a touch. So, quiet amount. I mean, velocity is probably about 12 o'clock. Envelope amount is about sort of 1, 2 o'clock. So light, dark, brighter. Now, if that's not bright enough for you, you can just add a little bit of cutoff. And one thing we haven't done is the release. So release again is like somebody grabbing the cutoff knob and just turn it straight off when there isn't any. So we just increase that a bit because we've already added a fair bit of release for the amp. Now that again is sometimes quite good to modulate that. But if you're using things like delays, then you know, you don't really hear it that much. You can use it like a pseudo reverb if you like, which is how, you know, a lot of synth sounds were sort of made with old vintage gear, using sort of long releases to try and mimic some kind of reverb, because, well, digital effects in the 70s didn't exist, obviously, and some of the early 80s ones cost a fortune. So that's fine. So we've got two oscillators, we've got the envelopes set up, and we've got a bit of pan spread. So I'm happy with that. We're going to write that, but remember what it does to edit layer B. So write, write again, and it's turned off edit layer B, which is a nightmare. It should stay that. And I do have the latest version as of this date. So edit layer B again. Keep that pushed in, otherwise you'll be changing the first one, the first layer. So now what we need to do is turn on the arp, and so I've got it going up and down. You could have it, you know, whichever way you need to, really. There's not a huge amount of different ones, up and down, random, speaks for itself, assign is whatever order you play your notes. So up and down will do for now. You have to excuse me. Sorry, I'm trying not to do videos where I cut them, so things don't jump. It's dedication, this, isn't it? So we've got that. Bit of panning, left and right. Bit of velocity. Now, one thing we did do was mess with the oscillator mix. So what we're going to do is do use a an LFO for that. So we're going to select LFO 1, going to go clock sync, because we want to sync it to the tempo. If you didn't have that, it'd just be free running, whatever the frequency of the LFO is. So if you set it really slow, it wouldn't have anything to do with the tempo. So, but we will have clock sync. Key sync is that it will essentially restart every time you push the key. But we don't have to worry about that for now. We're going to go triangle. So it'll be ramping up the amount of change and then going down slowly. It's a more even one. It doesn't stand out so much in your ears. So we've got LFO 1, that's the source, and then our sort of destination will be, well, why don't we hold down LFO 1, go to oscillator mix and wiggle that. So LFO 1's the source. Now the destination is oscillator 1 mix. And you'll find now that the frequency are all in steps rather than numbers from 1 to silly amounts. Now if we have key sync, it'd re-trigger every single time that the note is re-triggering. And because it's an arpeggiator, it's only a short amount of notes, so it's not going to go through an LFO cycle, if you know what I mean. So we're going to keep it kind of free running. Let's have it for now, four steps. Yep. And then just slowly bring up the amount. Let's change the steps, make it a little bit slower. And speed it up and it'll go a bit crackers. Now, this is an interesting point, really. You can get a kind of impression of having two notes within one if you double up the speed of the LFO and use square wave. Works well with assigning that rather than to the oscillator mix. Works well, assign it to the filter. Something I use a fair bit for some of my sounds. It gives a kind of 8-bit sound sometimes. But anyway, let's go back to where we were. Go triangle, and I think something slow. Something about 8 steps. It sounds a bit like a kind of phaser. Like a wah-rah thing, but it's all we're doing is just changing from the volume from oscillator 1 to 2. Just that. Someone grabbing that and just moving it. And it's kind of getting ow-wow sort of tone to it. By the way, if you hear some clicks and things like that, I've had a nightmare trying to get this audio routed properly. I'm trying to come up with a different way of doing things. So I've noticed on the streams that 1 minute it's kind of bright and then it goes a little bit dark, and I'm using this loopback thing, and yeah, it's a bit of a nightmare. But anyway, that's fine. Now, what we could do to double up on that, we could utilize a mod slot because we've already got that clock synced. So let's go to the source of mod slot. And the source of that will be LFO 1, because we're doubling up. Destination could be, what should we have? Why don't we have the filter release? Yeah. Now, it won't do anything yet, because we haven't added any amount, but we'll just play it, and then we'll increase the amount. Very subtle. Because it is very slow, utilize another LFO for that. So why don't we change the source of mod slot, the source from LFO 1 to LFO 2, onto LFO 2, clock sync. And for this, we want something rather fast. So we could have just gone LFO 2, assigned that was the source, and then just assigned it to to the release. But as we've already done it, you know, there's many ways to do this. So it's by having it a little bit quicker, the frequency, I think I've got it on about an 8th step. We will key sync it, so it will re-trigger each time. Down to the amount. Mm-hmm. So that's what that's doing, is just slightly changing the release. Stick it on random, actually. So it randomly changed the release. Okay, happy with that. So we could use LFO 3 for a bit of cutoff. So hold down that, hit the cutoff. Again, what we may do actually, clock sync. Yeah, we'll clock sync it, but I'm thinking of two different things actually, is one doing it really slow over time or really, really quick. But let's just leave it for quite slow, I reckon, over 16 steps, and then add the amount. Now, of course, when we're adding an amount, we're not adding anything in our minds negative like you can do with the mod slots, but we are actually, because it's going through zero the shape, so there is actually a brightness and a darkness. But I'm thinking of something even slower than that. Now, the slowest thing on that is 32 steps. Which is probably just about as fast as I want it to go. Now, a lot of the times what I would do is just turn that off and then just dial in as much as I want. So it's free running. Which I prefer, because you're hearing the changes of the release of the filter better, because it's changing the cutoff. Do is push down the hold and then mess around with, say, like the resonance, to see if changes of that over time is going to add anything to it. It's bringing out some more textures. Kind of like that. What I'm thinking right now is I don't want it on all the time, so I want to be able to control the resonance. So we'll give this one a go. I haven't tried this yet, I'm just thinking of it right now, which is to assign. Yeah, what we'll do, we'll hold down LFO4, assign that to resonance. We can then have clock sync, have it maybe on 8 steps. So that's on like 77. So what's happening now, LFO4 is modulating the resonance knob. It's synced over 8 steps. But I think what we will do is turn off the amount. So it's not doing anything. And we're going to use a mod slot to control the amount of that LFO via the mod wheel. So the source of this is going to be mod wheel. The destination is going to be LFO 4 amount. And the amount will be positive by, oh no, we'll just exaggerate it for now. So 127. So right now we don't have any resonance on. Make sure there isn't any resonance on, sorry. Now, what we're going to do now is move the mod wheel forward, and that will increase the amount of LFO4, which, as what we've done, is assign that to resonance. Now, of course, resonance can really stand out more when you reduce the cutoff. So what we can also do is go into our mod slot, change the mod slot to a different number, mod slot 3. Again, our source can be the mod wheel. Need to duplicate that. I don't know why it's not letting me do it that way. So our source is mod wheel, and our destination is going to be filter cutoff. So it'll say cutoff, but we want a negative amount there. So we're going to reduce that by, say, I don't know, 40 for now. Yeah. So what will happen is we'll bring up the mod wheel. It'll add a lot of resonance, but it'll also close the filter a little. Change the amount. It's down to 51 now. But of course, we've got an LFO that's going through and opening and closing the filter over time. So we've got all these things going on at the same time. So let's kind of summarize where we are with things. But what we will do is hit right. Again, edit layer B is turned off, so make sure you hit it. It's annoying. So if we've got 4 LFOs in use, they're being assigned to different things, such as cutoff, the resonance, the filter envelope release, and the oscillator 1 mix. We're also reusing or recycling, repurposing mod slots. So we're using the mod wheel. LFO2 is going to the release of the filter. Mod wheel is controlling LFO4's amount, which we've routed LFO4 to the resonance. So all we're doing, even though there's a lot of this sounds quite confusing, is it's just we don't have enough hands and arms to do all these changes at the same time. So these are like, we're offloading some of that, those things. But of course, as I say, we can repurpose. So mod slot 2 is using the mod wheel, but also using the mod wheel again for controlling the cutoff. Now, we've also got to bear in mind, though, that we're going to have this pad, this big, thick pad underneath. So we're probably going to have to reduce the volume of that pad quite a lot. Now, let's get into some effects for this. Now, we used delays on the pad, but we used it modulated at a very sort of short rate to create chorus. So we want really delays. Delays and arpeggiated sounds just go together perfectly. So let's turn it on. Let's find, I prefer BBDs. We've already using pan spread for stereo. So BBDs, it will pick up on that, but it'll still stay down the middle. It won't be panning ping pong stuff. Now that's totally out of time at the moment. So hit clock sync. That's quite a lot of feedback. So feedback, I've got about 32. But with it being BBDs, they'll get darker. Now, what I like, because we've got clock sync, I kind of like dotted eighths because they create a counter rhythm. Now, when we've got a big pad underneath that, a lot of that is going to disappear. You won't hear the repeats. So we'll turn up the mix a bit more, and yeah, I will bring up the feedback. But I'll try not to have the first delay louder than the actual source sound. So that's still about 41. So what we're going to do now is I like that. Let's write the sound. Now, it's turned off edit layer B, which in this case, this is what we want because we're going to bring in the pad now. So we turn it down. So program volume, we're probably only going to need it around 80, something like that. Otherwise, we'll start losing that arpeggiator. So let's bring it up 81. To about 90, but of course if we want to take it over, what we have done in the previous thing with the pad is we assigned the aftertouch to we made it brighter slightly. Strange sounds happening. So that will give, well, we'll hear it. I'll push harder. Resonance. Now we could probably go a little bit louder actually on that pad, so around 99, 100, something like that. But of course, we've got things assigned to the mod wheel, haven't we? So, sorry for this clicking. It's really doing me a bit. And there's pretty much a layered pad and arpeggiator. I mean, you could increase the range of the octaves for the arpeggiator, change the divide, add some more delays, your stereo delays, whatever you want. So what I will do now is play the sound without the clicky clacky, and then with some effects, and then you'll hear what it can kind of sound like. That's that, and now I'll add a bit of external reverb. Now this might click. I've got two Personas Quantums, and they just do not like each other as an aggregate device together over word clock. Nightmare. Anyway, here it is. Might work now. And in case you're wondering, that's a Strymon Big Sky. But of course, you know, I think there's plugins like Valhalla, which can do that kind of big cavernous reverb. So maybe try those. But yeah, that's that. And there'll be more coming.